Good morning, YouTube. Following up on my solar clothes dryer video, I thought I would try running my old energy inefficient clothes washer on solar power. So let's see if it fires up. So I've got it set here. I will run this here. There we go. That's starting up. Let's go out and take a look at what the inverter power looks like. So let's see, we're sitting right now at 2.15 kilowatt hours. That's how much I've run through the inverter this month. We can watch the watts. So that's just got the fill valve running now, 10 watts. Up here is the current going into the inverter, 3.7 amps. The washer should be getting ready to kick on. There we go, 400, 600 watts. Roughly 60 amps going into the inverter, coming out of the batteries. So I think this is the agitator cycle. And let's see here, we're pulling about 44 amps out of the batteries. And I'll swing up here to the charge controller. Pulling about 30 amps off the panels. And actually what I'll do is I'll go shut off some of my DC lights. Yeah, so there I shut off some of my DC lights, and you can see we're up right around 40 amps. That's a 40 amp charge controller. Yeah, definitely plugging that capacitor in makes a difference there. It's plugged in now, so I'm doing about 25 amps out of the battery bank, if you can read that. So that's this meter here. So we got 25.8, so run right around 25 amps. I'll pull the run capacitor out, and let's see what this goes up to here. You can see now it's climbing. So now it's doing 30, so it's about 5 extra amps have to go to the inverter to supply the reactive power of the washing machine motor. There it hit 31. Now I plug the capacitor in and it's dropping back down. So that's saving, yeah, there it's 24, 23. Yeah, that's almost 8 amps difference. Yeah, you can see there we're at 23, 22. You can see the watts didn't change. Even though the reactive power isn't real power, it's still amps, and you still have AC amps that you've got to put out. And we can probably watch that current here. Let's see what. So we've got 7.3, and now it's 8.4. So you can see it, that extra amp of AC current needs about 8 amps of DC current. Every amp you don't push out of the inverter is probably 8 amps that you don't have to push into it. Okay, and there it's, I guess, on a soak cycle. It slowed down a little bit. Okay, so this is the tricky part of the cycle here. There we go. So you can see the inverter is a little upset. We're running over the limit. That was, what, 11 amps for a while. That's the hard part there, where it's got to start up the spin cycle, where it's spinning the water out of the wet clothes. So you've got all that heavy inertia to spin up, and it takes a while. Yeah, I could always get a bigger inverter, but you can see with my charge controller and the panels that I have, I can only sustain 40 amps of charging current. And at 12 volts, that's a, you know, 450 or 500 watts continuous load. I guess at some point you could put a 2 or 3,000 watt inverter there, but you can still only run maybe 500 watts continuous. And then there we go. There's the startup. And you can see there it started up pretty quietly. It didn't complain. Okay, there is the end of the agitate cycle. And you can see our power, we're at a little over a kilowatt right there. And there it complains when it gets over 1,000. So I'll come back when this finishes, and then we can see how many kilowatt hours were used in the one cycle of the machine. So I'll come back when that's finished. So we've settled back down. I'll unplug my capacitor there. Let's see how much power I think it was 2.13, something like that. So right around 300 watt hours or 0.3 kilowatt hour to run a load of clothes. That's not a huge amount of power, but kind of a challenging load. I think I'll give my charge controller a little bit to catch up. I got to take the clothes out of the machine, hang them up to dry. We'll run a second load here. We'll see what that looks like. I'll come back and so this is 2.43 kilowatt hours at the end of the first load, and we can take a look at the end of the second load, see if it works a little better here. So I'll touch base when I get the second load run.